Two of the hottest mobiles of the moment are undoubtedly Google's new Nexus phones, the Nexus 5X and the Nexus 6P. But how do they stack up to two of the best Androids of 2015 so far? The Sony Xperia Z5 and the Samsung Galaxy S6. The Nexus 5X isn't much of a looker with a super serious all-black plastic design, but its bigger brother, the 6P, restores some serious street cred with an attractive and durable metal frame. It's the biggest phone here by far, but the slender curved design thankfully means that it's not too uncomfortable to wield. However, we still prefer the gorgeous glass and metal design of the Galaxy S6 and the Xperia Z5, which offers a very different look and feel to the Nexus handsets. And while the Galaxy S6 is a bit of a fingerprint magnet, the Xperia Z5's textured surface helps to keep it smudge-free. Sony's phone is the only water-resistant effort here, but all four phones pack a fingerprint scanner for keeping your private bits secure. That's great news if you suck at remembering PIN codes like us. But bear in mind that while all four scanners can be used to unlock the phones, only the Galaxy S6s can be used to verify PayPal transactions. And the S6 is the only phone to pack a heart rate sensor in case you're one of them types that does exercise all the time. The Xperia Z5 and the Nexus 5X are closely matched when it comes to displays, both rocking a 5.2-inch Full HD screen. With 428 pixels crammed into every square inch, images are more than sharp enough to enjoy high-def movies. Samsung's Galaxy S6 boasts a better Quad HD resolution, which packs an impressive 577 pixels per inch. That's probably the most stunning screen that we've ever seen on a smartphone. And the Nexus 6P also has a Quad HD panel, this one a mighty 5.7 inches, making it easy on the eyes if you watch a lot of video on the go. Now, if you generally carry around a lot of apps and media, then heed our warning. The Galaxy S6 and both Nexus phones don't have a microSD memory card slot. On the S6 and the 6P, you can stump up for a 64GB plus model, but the 5X only comes in 16 and 32GB flavors. So, in that case, you might want to check out the Xperia Z5 instead, which supports memory cards up to 200GB. All four phones here pack a bit of Android, but only the new Nexus phones have a tasty bit of marshmallow installed. For the Z5 and the S6, you'll have to wait for the manufacturers to update them. The good news is that Android runs beautifully on each of these handsets, with smooth everyday performance from the Snapdragon chips stuffed inside the Nexus phones and the Xperia Z5. Samsung bucked trend with its own Exynos 7420 processor, which benchmarks even better than the others here and proves perfect for high-intensity gaming. All four phones here support quick charge, typically given around 3 to 4 hours of use from just 10 minutes of charging, although Google does reckon that the Nexus 6P will enjoy closer to 6 or 7 hours of life from the same amount of charge. The new Nexus phones also boast Type-C USB ports, which are fully reversible, while the Galaxy S6 support wireless charging. If you're a budding photographer, you'll definitely be happy with all four phones here. To start with, both Nexus handsets pack a 12.3 megapixel Sony sensor, complete with an infrared-assisted autofocus to take sharp shots the second you hit the shutter button. The Sony Xperia Z5 also boasts a super-fast autofocus in its more powerful 23 megapixel camera, which, like the Nexus phones, can deliver excellent low-light performance. And that superior auto mode also helps to keep things sharp and clear in a wide variety of conditions. And then there's the Samsung Galaxy S6. The 16 megapixel rear camera is impressively accurate, capably coping with everything you throw its way, and producing gloriously realistic colours. All four phones here can also record in Full HD and 4K. But if you are going to shoot in 4K, you'll definitely want a phone with plenty of storage space. For a full Android phone comparison and full reviews of each of these phones, check out recombu.com/mobile. Well, we took to the streets of London with all four phones and snapped the following photos using the full auto mode for a direct comparison. In tricky high contrast situations, the Xperia Z5 seems to come out the best, with lighter buildings packing a pleasing amount of detail despite that harsh glare in sky.